Hello everyone, today we are here to discuss about the diseases of mustard crop. In that we discuss the different kinds of diseases that causes the severe losses in yield. So out of the different diseases, first disease is called as Alternaria leaf blight or leaf spot. The causal organism is Alternaria brassicola or brassici, that is fungal disease. Regarding symptoms, the leaf spot of Alternaria brassicola that appears as a small dark colored areas. That small brown colored spots, they increase in their size, it becomes circular or they increase in their size, and that brown to black colored spots are increase in their size and connected with each other or coalesces with each other, and due to that large lesions is observed on the leaves. If at the same time in atmosphere humid weather or humid condition is there, so large lesions with concentric rings are observed on the leaves. Here the large lesions are observed on the leaves with the concentric rings. So this is the typical symptoms. If the infestation is severe, so that spot or the linear spot is appears on the different parts of the plants. For example, the spot is appears on the petioles, stem and the seed pods. And due to that, if the infestation is takes place on the pods, so pod formation is not takes place first of all. And if the pod is formed, so seed which is present inside or seed formation inside the pod is not, does not takes place regularly. So this is the typical symptoms. The next one is the if the infestation of Alternaria raphani species that appears, so they first attack on the seed plants on the leaves as a yellow raised spot. So this is the symptoms of Alternaria spot or blight. Regarding perpetuation, here the primary source of infection is plant debris and seeds, and secondary source of infection is airborne conidia. Regarding management strategy, okay, so we can do the hot water treatment for the seeds at a 50 degree Celsius for 30 minutes. That eradicate the fungus which is present on the seeds. Also, we follow the crop rotation by avoiding the cruciferous crops and eradicate the susceptible weeds. The next, we have to spray if the infestation is severe. So we have to spray the chemicals at early stages of the crop with COC, that is copper oxychloride, at a rate of 0.5 to 0.75%, or Zynep 0.25% for control of that disease. Next one, the next disease is called as the white rust. One of the most important and typical disease is observed in cruciferous crop, mostly on the mustard. So that white rust is caused by the fungus albigo candida. Regarding symptoms, in case of that white rust, there are two types of symptoms is occurred. First one is local symptoms and second one is systemic symptoms. In case of local symptoms, the pustules or sori that develop in leaves and stem, that sori are closer and merged to form, that sori that are merged with each other and to form a large patches here. As we indicated here, the large patches are observed due to the sori are connected with each other. And if the sori that increase in their size, so the host epidermis ruptures after the maturity of that pustules. When the young stem and flowering parts are infected, the fungus becomes systemic in tissue and stimulate the hypertrophy and hyperplasia symptoms. And due to that hypertrophy and hyperplasia symptoms, entire parts of the plants increase in their size. For example, the distortion of organs, that is enlargement of different sepals, petals of each and every part of the plant increase in their size tremendously. So due to the systemic infection, hypertrophy and hyperplasia, that symptoms is occurred on the different parts of the plants. So this is about symptoms. Regarding perpetuation, primary source of infection is the oospores in plant debris or in the soil, and secondary source of infection is takes place through sporangia, which is carried out by air currents or air. Regarding management strategy, you have to spray with borax mixture at a rate of 0.8%. It is effective for control of that disease. Then we have to diseased plant debris should be destroyed or plowed, or plowing should be done regularly. If the infestation is severe, so spray the chemical, that is difolatin 0.3% or chlorothalonil or metalaxyl 0.1%. Here next disease is called as in the downy mildew disease of that cruciferous crop. In that downy mildew, it is caused due to the fungus Peronospora parasitica. Regarding symptoms, the spot of fluffy white fungal growth appears on the lower leaves, stem, seed pods as a purplish irregular areas. That means on the lower surface of the leaves, a whitish mycelial growth is observed, or the whitish pustules are observed on the lower surface of leaves. And if you observe on the upper surface of leaves, a yellow patch or yellow colored spot are observed on the upper surface of leaves. So this is the typical symptoms of the downy mildew fungus. Mostly what happens, and if the condition is suitable or favorable, for example cool or moist condition is there, so that whitish spot enlarge indefinitely to form yellow areas on upper side, as we discussed previously, and on the corresponding side a whitish mycelial or fungal growth is observed. When maturating heads are infected, so it purplish spots is appears on the heads. So this is about the typical symptoms. Then if the infection is done systemically, so it invades the tissue, and the tissue of that leaves turns yellowish and it becomes necrotic over indefinite area of midrib and blade. After that, sometimes the seedlings, or if the infection is takes place on cotyledons or hypocotyl of cabbage seedlings in cool and moist climate, so such a seedlings are died or killed, or a damping of symptoms is takes place. So this is about the important symptoms of that downy mildew. Regarding perpetuation, here regarding perpetuation, the perpetuation is our primary source of infection is takes place through the infected plant debris or through the seeds, and secondary spread is takes place through the airborne or windborne conidia. Then regarding management strategies, to avoid that downy mildew, the soil should be well drained, or clean soil we have to use. Then second one, if the infestation is severe, so we have to spray the borax mixture at a rate of 1%, or instead of borax mixture we also spray the mancozeb or zyneb at a rate of 0.2%. Then regarding last disease, that is called as sclerotiana stem rot. So as we know that sclerotia or sclerotiana stem rot, it is caused due to the fungus, that is sclerotiana sclerotianum. So that sclerotia is nothing but, or that sclerotia which is present in soil, so that's why it is called as soil borne disease. So that sclerotiana fungus, they directly attack near to the stem. Due to that, water soaked spots will be developed on the stem, and that stem is surrounded by the white cottony growth. As the disease progress, affected portion of the stem, it develop the bleached or blighted appearance. If the infestation is severe, so girdling of the stem is takes place that result in premature ripening or lodging of the plants. If the infestation is severe, so near the stem, here near the stem, if you split the stem, so a blackish or brownish mustard like spot is observed inside the stem. So this is the typical characteristics of that sclerotia, that is blackish or brownish mustard like seeds, or mustard like seeds like sclerotia will be observed, or so sclerotia will be observed inside the stem. If the infestation is severe, so yield will be lost up to 10 to 15%. It is a highly infectious disease in case of that crop. Then regarding the perpetuation, the fungus will be survive in sclerotia in soil or in plant debris, and secondary source of infection is through wind or water. So regarding these management strategies, we can do the deep summer plowing or field sanitation, and we also use the resistant variety for the control of that disease. Then we also apply the biocontrol agent like Trichoderma to the seeds, or also we have to do the drenching of Trichoderma to the soil to reduce the wilting symptoms. So this is about the last disease of that fungus, or last disease of that crop. Thank you.